Hello and welcome to a new series of films which I'm calling the Cellar Sessions, because I'm shooting them all in the cellar. Partly because it's such a cold time of year and very difficult to film outside. So here we go with the first in the series, and this one is called Secrets and Lies. Something I've been doing a lot of this winter is taking in stories, people's stories, from films, old TV series, books, and listening to people, and remembering about my life and other people's lives. And this is a constant theme that I witness over and over again, which is that everyone I've ever met, and I certainly include myself, have done things at some point in our lives that we're really not proud of, that we don't feel good about at all. Usually to do with hurting another person, often unintentionally, sometimes intentionally. And so this is what I want to focus in on, this whole subject of secrets and lies. And particularly if you watch any of the soaps, you will see these themes enacted over and over again, really repetitively, which is that someone does something in their past that they're not proud of, and then they meet new people, and they get together with a new person as a friendship or as a relationship, and there are these secrets which they feel reluctant to share. And when the people get really close, when there's genuine intimacy, there arises a possibility, which is that you reach the point where you trust this person so much that you start to reveal your secrets. And I guess I want to define things into two kinds of secrets. One is the secret of things that you've suffered, and the other is the secrets of where you've caused somebody else to suffer. And these things are not easy to reveal, whichever way around it is. Often when the person is on the verge of revealing a secret about something they've suffered, they carry a sense of shame about this and a sense of being unworthy, perhaps even of being filthy. These are common qualities in this situation. And then when a person has done something in the past that they feel really bad about, because they know it was a wrong thing to have done, that they hurt someone, either intentionally or unintentionally, that causes a lot of guilt. And so these emotions can cause us to hold back. The most recent story I read, which is in a book that was published this year, was about a couple who get together, and the woman has experienced unspeakably horrible suffering as having been someone that was imported into this country to be a sex slave. And her partner appears to be this really good guy, and he is, and they both are. They're both really lovely, wonderful people that have been through a lot. And there reaches a point where each of them is so burdened by the secrets which they're holding that they really want to share with the other. And they don't quite trust, they don't quite make the leap. And I have this experience myself with one particular partner, where there are certain things that I wanted to share about myself, some of my personal secrets, and I held back. And then, sometime later, one of these secrets ended up being revealed by a third party. And this is exactly the thing which I've observed again and again in the stories which I've been taking in, is that when a third party reveals the information, then this wonderful opportunity has been lost. And it's something that's rather irrecoverable, really pretty hard to retrieve a situation of this magnitude. And so my invitation to you is that when you feel close enough to a person to trust them, and that is important, you do need to have this sense of trust before you feel like you can even consider revealing a secret. But when you reach that point of trust with that person and you've tested the water by revealing a couple of minor things and you know it works well, this person does have genuine understanding of you, then I invite you to take that risk and take that leap. Because looking back, I can see that I lost that relationship by not taking that extra step towards sharing my personal details with that person. And so this is what I want to draw the picture to, because eventually in the story I'm talking about the English guy and the foreign woman, and they've both got their terrible things that they want to reveal to each other, eventually all sorts of horrific things happen. There's a lot of suffering for both of them, and finally the Englishman travels all the way to the woman's native land, and they meet, and he reveals what he was unable to reveal before, and it is something that is really disturbing, and it's such a risk that he takes. And yet what you can see in this story, and you see this again and again in fiction, when the person reaches that point and they do share, so long as the trust is there, it's like they're giving the person a great gift. And the gift is the gift of understanding, because what it comes down to is this: information. It's all about information. The more information we have about any situation, the more we're capable of understanding it. I had this myself in the last week when someone gave me a little bit more information about their circumstances, then I could understand so much better where they were coming from. Having more understanding gives empathy, enables the hearts to open even more, which is all about opening up the space of love. And this is the ultimate gift of revealing your secrets to someone that you love and trust. It's the space of love that you create between each other becomes deeper and stronger, and the understanding between you becomes so much more profound and ultimately helpful. So when it comes down to secrets and lies, yeah, lies, let's look at the other side of the picture, lies. There are so many people that have hidden and have lied about things that they've done in the past. And I'm talking about people in the news, celebrities. We've only got to think about Jimmy Savile. The most recent one is one of the monarchy, Prince Andrew. We've got the guy who Prince Andrew is connected with. Lots of young girls, it's the usual story. So secrets do get found out, and we are living in a time when more and more often this is happening. And thus, let's look at the lie in detail. The lie that a person's tempted to take, let's take it away from the big picture of the celebrities and the royals and just into our personal situation. There's a trick which you can play on yourself, and it goes like this. What I'll do is I'll tell a person a lie about this to keep my secret concealed, and I'll do this because I want to protect them. I don't want to burden them. I don't want them to have to deal with my... You can see where this is coming from. And whenever we go to this place, it sounds so altruistic. It sounds so kind and generous. And yet it isn't, because if you look right underneath, you'll discover it's not about the other person. The choice to lie is always about the self, wanting to protect the self, but putting it in the guise of protecting the other. And I want to give a really extreme example, which is something I caught a long time ago on a national English radio station called Radio 4. Two people with cancer, and they both have children. And the filmmakers, the radio producers made a study of these two cases. And in the one case, the person told their child, a young child, that they had cancer. In the other case, they told the lie. They pretended that there was nothing wrong. It became so clear as the research unfolded and as the radio program went into the detail that the child that knew the truth was the child that had received the gift. And the child that had been protected by not being allowed to know what was wrong with that particular parent was the child that felt cheated, and the child that ultimately didn't feel trust and understanding from the parent. So even in really serious cases when we think, maybe we really do need to protect the person, so long as it's done in the right way. And that was what was so clear. The person who did have the illness that told the child that it is in such a helpful way, and it meant a bond between the two of them was so much stronger. So my advice to you is to reveal the secrets you can to the people that you feel you can trust and love, and allow this to be a gift of love and understanding between the two of you. Thank you very much.